First, let's watch a short video.
如果你已经玩腻了传统的 Web UI， 感觉创作受到了限制，那么 it's time to meet ComfyUI。这不仅仅是一个新界面。
So, what did you notice in that video? Of course, it's an AI-generated video, but the key is the voice. First, it's quite expressive and emotional. Second, it seamlessly mixes both Chinese and English. The overall performance is excellent, and the transition between languages is very smooth. This technology is what we're introducing today, ATTS, Text-to-Speech Model, or rather, a voice cloning model from Microsoft called VibeVoice. So, what are the key features of VibeVoice? First, the voices it generates are highly expressive, and it can handle very long text inputs. How long, you ask? It can generate up to 90 minutes of audio from a single text prompt. Moreover, it supports multi-speaker conversations with up to 4 different people. This makes it an excellent choice if you want to generate long-form podcasts. Currently, it offers 2 models, a 1.5B and a 7 bytes version. As we'll see, the performance difference between them is quite significant, which we'll explore in our tests later. All right, let's dive into how the VibeVoice workflow is implemented. Here is the basic layout of the workflow. It's very simple, with just one core node, VibeVoice TTS, which comes from the ComfyUI VibeVoice extension. What you're seeing now is the extension's GitHub page. Installation is also quite straightforward. First, you need to clone the repository. Then, navigate into the installation directory and run pip install ourrequirements.txt to install all the dependencies. After that, just restart ComfyUI. The first time you run the node, it will automatically download the necessary models. As mentioned, there are 2 models, a 1.5B version and a large 7B version. The generation length and context window for each are different. To generate audio as long as 90 minutes, it uses a sliding window technique. The context windows for the 2 models are different. One is 64K and the other is 32K. Ultimately, this affects the maximum audio length. If you use the 1.5B model, you can generate 90 minutes of audio, but if you use the 7B model, you're limited to 45 minutes. Of course, in terms of quality, the 7B model is significantly superior to the 1.5B model. Now, let's take a look at the basic workflow test. Let's quickly go over this node. It has 4 optional inputs for speaker underscore voice, allowing for up to 4 cloned voices. If you don't provide an audio sample, it will use a built-in default voice. Our first test will focus on its long text and mixed Chinese-English capabilities. Here's our text. It contains both Chinese and English, mixed together with about a 50-50th split. For the voice we're cloning, we'll use a sample of Donald Trump's voice.
We know technology is advancing quickly, but AI is moving even faster.
Now, for some important parameters. First is model underscore name. We'll start with the 1.5B model, which is generally sufficient for single-speaker use. For quality reasons, I'll turn quantization off for now. For the attention mechanism, I've selected SDPA. The CFG value determines how closely the generated output follows the prompt. For sampling steps, 10 can work, but for ideal results, you might want to set it to 30. We'll set the seed to random. Now, pay attention to this important setting, do underscore sample. This can be a bit tricky to understand, but you can think of it as determining whether the output should be deterministic. Enabling it can greatly enhance the consistency between the input and output, but you might get fewer surprise or creative results. We'll set temperature and top underscore K to 0.95. I'll leave force underscore offload enabled, depending on your hardware. Okay, let's listen to the result.
Now it's time to meet ComfyUI. 这不仅仅是一个新界面, it represents a complete paradigm shift in how we interact with stable diffusion models.
All right, let's stop there. The first thing you'll notice is the language mixing. The English part for Trump's voice sample is flawless and performs perfectly. But you'll notice the Chinese part is spoken with a distinct accent. This is actually a feature of the model. Since we provided a purely English audio sample, the model analyzed its characteristics and preserved that English accent when cloning the voice to speak Chinese. It sounds a lot like an English speaker trying to speak Chinese. So, we've confirmed it handles long text well. Its mixed language generation is impressive, and its ability to create accented speech is very interesting. This is something you can compare against other models, like Spark TTS or Mega TTS 3. Also, take note of the required format in the prompt. You need to write Speaker 1 before the text. Next, let's try another voice. We'll use the same text, but switch the voice sample to that of Lu Yu, a famous Chinese host.
就你就看到一个一个数字，然后尤其是你有一段，你能够明显感到你处于一个瓶颈期的时候。
We'll stick with the 1.5B model for this clone. Let's hear the result.
如果你已经玩腻了传统的WebUI，感觉创作受到了限制，那么 it's time to meet ComfyUI. 这不仅仅是一个新界面，it represents a complete paradigm shift in how we interact with stable diffusion models.
As you can hear, I can't really tell if her English has an accent, but her Chinese pronunciation is quite standard. However, you'll find that the similarity of the cloned voice isn't as high as we might have hoped. There are some noticeable changes in timbre. So, that's a characteristic of the 1.5B model. Now for another test, this time with two voices. We have Lu Yu's voice and Trump's voice.
你会想,哦,数字好冷静,但冷静的背后...
It's already transforming our lives from the way...
We're going to simulate a multi-person dialogue, like a back-and-forth in a podcast. The first speaker will speak Chinese, and the second will speak English, using the Speaker 1 and Speaker 2 format. But the main goal here isn't just to test multi-speaker dialogue, it's to test emotion. I've designed a dialogue where two people are arguing about which is better, French fries or fried chicken. We are testing if the model can capture the emotion of an argument. Let's listen to how they performed.
不是,我真的不明白我们为什么还要讨论这个话题。答案已经很明显了,薯条才是快餐界的绝对王者,毫无疑问。你想想看,那种外表金黄酥脆,内里柔软绵密的完美口感,咬下去咔嚓一声,那是艺术。
Whoa, hold on a second. Art? You're calling a glorified potato stick? Art, that's absurd. Fried chicken is the true masterpiece.
Okay, let's stop there. There's definitely some emotion there. You can tell they are arguing, and the language delivery is good. However, the cloned timbre is still a bit off, and the emotion doesn't quite reach the level we'd hoped for. This was still using the 1.5B model. Let's do one more test with two Chinese voices, Lu Yu and Andy Lau.
就你又看到一个一个数字。所以我觉得这些成功的电影。Same
argument, 1.5B model.
不是,我真的不明白我们为什么还要讨论这个话题。答案已经很明显了,薯条才是快餐界的绝对王者。哇,
等一下,艺术,你管一根美化过的土豆条叫艺术。
The basic timbre is there, and there's a hint of emotion, but again, it's not strong enough. Now, let's make a small change. We'll switch to the large 7B model, using the same two voices and prompt, and listen to the result.
不是,我真的不明白我们为什么还要讨论这个话题。答案已经很明显了。啊,薯条才是快餐界的绝对王者。哇,等一下,艺术,你管一根美化过的土豆条叫艺术,太荒谬了。Wow,
the timbre is incredibly similar, and the emotion is spot on, right? So, the key takeaway is, for multi-speaker conversations where emotion and accuracy are important, I highly recommend using the 7B large model for much better results. VibeVoice also has another very interesting feature. It can capture background music. I haven't tested this myself, but if you clone a voice that has music in the background, you might hear that music in the final output. Does it have any weaknesses? Yes, it does. Try to avoid generating very short audio clips. Let me show you an example. I'll use only the first speaker and just the first word of the dialogue. Let's generate that. As you can see, there's a problem. It can't generate it properly. So, for ultra-short texts, it's best to avoid using this model, as the results can be unpredictable. This is something I discovered during my testing. Alright, that's all for today. What are you waiting for? Go ahead and try it for yourself. Follow me and become more AI savvy.